Hello, good day again, class. This is a continuation of our lecture on performance analysis under farm planning and budgeting. And this time, after we were done with profitability or even the performance analysis of agricultural technology, now we will go into another measure of performance, that is investment viability. From the looks of it, or from the name itself, investment viability, that means it is actually, from the vantage point of time, it is actually an investment or an asset allocation, or a budget that goes beyond 1, 2 or several years. That means it is an asset allocation that is multi-period, or that has to last in terms of several periods of time. So that's why we use investment analysis to view the viability of agricultural production technologies and determine whether that investment is worthwhile or not worthwhile pursuing. So to start with, there are various tools for measuring financial viability of agricultural technologies. This time, it's post-harvest technologies, okay? Now, the effect of technology on farm business operation actually is viewed, or can be viewed, in terms of angles. One is, technology can either increase production, or technology can either also reduce cost of operation. So either way, when you get a positive result, then it is a viable, or it is a worthwhile technology. But it depends on the performance over time of that particular technology, okay? Now, note that either economic analysis or financial analysis, we use the values, we can use either of the values for profitability, depending on the purpose of the assessment. If you are very much after of net private, when I say private, that means to say your income as a firm, that means nominal, okay? When I say nominal, that is the price based on market price, okay? So that means nominal. If it is real price, that means based on the effect of inflation, okay? So it can either be financial, or it can also either be economic. But whether it be economic or financial values, we are talking, the methodology is just the same. Okay, there are two ways of assessing profitability. One is ex ante. When we say ex ante, that is before the fact. That means to say you are looking at future profitability. Okay, analysis is basically estimation of potential profit. That means it's still going to happen in the future. Okay, and then an example of this will be partial budget, and then you have NPV or net present value analysis, and others. The other way of assessing profitability is ex post, or after the fact. And the other one is before the fact. This one is after the fact. That means you want to see your performance last year, maybe 2 years ago. Okay, and then cast it forward and see what's going to happen likely in the future. Analysis of on the other hand is determination of the actual profit derived from production activity or farm operation of the technology. Okay, so that means if you compute for cost and return analysis, that is ex post analysis, because it's based on past data. If you compute for profitability of the farm last year, and you are going to see it now, that is ex post. Okay, so that means based on past data. Okay, now cost and return analysis. ex post analysis. That means to say, you get or you have a collection of past data. That means maybe last year's performance of the farm. That is ex post, no? And then do that for detailed accounting purposes for cost and return items. Now, steps for conducting or making or setting up your CNR analysis, cost and return analysis. Step one, you have set up all cost and return table, cash, non-cash, income, variable, and fixed cost, including cash and non-cash cost. Okay, and then you have also determined for income purposes or for determined items for income and expense headings. Income and then expense. What are your expenses, expenditures then? Compute the indicators of income, either net income or gross margin. Okay, the net income based on what? Based on past data is ex post analysis. Gross margin also based on past data. Okay, now the cost and return analysis. How to set up a cost and return analysis? And I think one of your classmates asked for this. How should we set up a cost and return analysis? Although this is downloadable, okay? The format, okay, the format of cost and return analysis, it's just simply like this, okay? You have the income and then the cost, okay? This is the format. So what are the sources of income or the streams of income? Cash income, non-cash income, and then total income. A plus B is total income. Then plug it here, and then the cost. The cost could either be total variable cost. So what are the total variable costs? Fertilizer, seeds, chemicals, etc. No? So you itemize it there. You can also have variable cost for labor. Okay, yeah, labor that is on-call labor. No? And then you have also fixed cost. Okay, you have also fixed cost. What are the fixed costs? Depreciation, interest expense on capital, and then you also have what? You also have say for example the money you use for salaried person or the workers that are what that are receiving monthly salary. Okay, that means regular workers. These are all fixed costs because they do not vary. The number of workers do not vary. The regular workers do not vary with the volume of production. Mo increase kag labor, it is because of the variable expense. Okay, and then you sum that up: total variable, napay variable non-cash cost, and total fixed non-cash cost. Okay, unsa man ang fixed non-cash cost? Depreciation is a fixed non-cash cost because it's only an attribution. You do not actually pay an out of the. It's not actually coming from out of pocket cost, and then you sum up everything. You get total cash cost, okay? Total cash cost, and then total cost. Oh, you have the formula also. F total cost plus I, which is total non-cash cost, equals total cost, and then you compute for net income. That means total income minus total cost. You get the gross margin, okay? So with that, we start with the income item. So this is how we compute for your income, cash, non-cash income, and then you sum up. At least you have already a summation of your income. And then you have also your cost, your variable cost, okay? What are your variable costs? Labor inputs. You have fertilization, irrigation, spraying, harvesting, etc., packaging. Those are variable labor inputs. Okay, and then you also have variable step continue with variable labor inputs. Cash cost, you have plowing, harrowing, bedding, manure application, seedling application, mulching, etc. No, transplanting. Those are all variable, no, variable labor cost, but that are variable. Then you have number of mandates, and then the total value, and then sum that up. And then variable cost, material. Kanina, variable cost, labor. Okay? This time, variable cost, material inputs. You have seeds, animal manure, fresh rice hull, carbonized rice hull, etc. No? This is a cost and return analysis of organic lettuce, no? And then you get the quantity figure and then the times the price, then you get the value per item, and then you sum that up. That is your total, say, fixed or variable cost. And then you have your cost item, variable cost, material cost, such bio-organic fertilizer, plastic mulch, and then you also have transportation, miscellaneous. Then you have the total variable cost. Okay, no? So the total variable cost, okay, the total variable cost, you add it to your fixed cost also. What are you, who are your fixed costs? How, where can you generate your fixed costs? Permanent labor or regular laborers, land rent, and then you have depreciation. Remember, depreciation is fixed non-cash cost. And then you sum that up, fixed cash cost plus fixed non-cash cost equals total fixed cost. In this case, 41,000. Okay, so you add the total cost, variable, and the fixed cost, you get the total cost. And then net income, the net income summation minus total cost, you get the gross margin. Okay, you get the gross margin. So with that, that is ex post financial statement using cost and return analysis. Another, say, tool for analyzing performance can be, which is ex ante, partial budgeting. Partial budgeting is an ex ante analysis, meaning to say before the fact. That means you are going to assess the change or the effect of a change in practice or effect in the change of technology, whatever, no? Sorry. Used to assess, ex ante used to assess economic viability of component technology. In this case, there are various components, no? Then assessment, the assess changes in methods of technology, adding new crop or livestock, substituting one crop with other livestock. That these are some of the possible change in practice or technology. No? Includes only the cost and outputs that alter as a result of the change. That is partial budgeting from our previous lecture. Now, steps in partial budgeting, one is describe the change, improvement or being considered. And then second one, list the quantity gains and losses from the specified change. Number three, calculate the change in net income or gross margin, gains minus losses. And then you have list other important non-monetary factors. Okay, so which can either be in the gains or which can either be in the losses column. Okay, so the framework of partial budgeting is this one. This is the tabular formula of a partial budget. We have this already in our previous lecture. So I'm just repeating this very quickly to really make an emphasis on this kind of steps, which is actually an ex post type of analysis, or not ex post, but ex ante type of analysis. Cost, added cost, and then you have also reduced return. That is, this is cost column, and then benefit column, reduced cost and added return. Okay, you add the gains minus the losses. If it is positive, then it's a desirable, say, for example, way to go. Okay, now the other method, though, aside from partial budgeting, is total or complete farm budgeting or enterprise budgeting. Okay, the enterprise budgeting is an ex ante analysis. That means you are budgeting as to what is going to happen in the next couple of years from now using your resources in the farm. Ex ante analysis used to assess economic viability of proposed, underscore the word proposed, cropping pattern, livestock production, or whatever scheme you have. Similar with cost and return analysis in format. Okay? For pareho format, ex ante lang. Okay? So this is return above cash cost, okay, equals gross income minus cash cost. And then you have, please take note, I'm going directly to the bottom portion of the, statement, cost and return, because this could be also used as an ex post. You can also make a projected cost and return analysis, which is ex ante, and the same method applies. The same steps applies, no? Only natalay ng gipuno. return above variable cost, or RAVC, is equals to gross income minus total variable cost. So return to labor, okay? Return to labor times the, or must exceed, okay? If you have return to labor, it must exceed the wage rate, okay? Return to labor, it must exceed the wage rate. That it happens in one of our projects like Abaca. We were actually trying to assess why will Abaca farmers shift to vegetable. Okay, there are a lot of number of Abaca farm changed to vegetable. So when we made an analysis, it was found out that return to labor for Abaca production is much lower than return to labor in vegetable production. Rational thinking, any person, any farmer, rationally will select where he's going to put his labor in an alternative that gives him more return. So that explains, no? Return to labor, which is return above variable cost plus labor divided by total labor input. Okay, that is return to labor. Remember the formula: you have return above return above variable cost, okay, plus labor divided by total labor input. Okay, return to labor must exceed wage rate. Remember, return to labor must exceed wage rate. Now, return to cash. Remember, I'm going directly to the formula. The reason is all these formulas are actually derivable from the cost and return analysis. Because cost and return analysis can either be ex post or ex ante. If you go for an ex ante, it is a projected cost and return analysis. That's why we injected some of these formulas in order to assess the, for example, return to cash. The formula is return above what? Return above cash cost over total cash cost. Marginal benefit cost ratio. Marginal benefit cost ratio, added benefit, okay, all over cost. That means value addition in terms of gross margin, okay, divided by added cost. Pilay imong ano, gross margin divided by added cost, that is your marginal benefit cost ratio, okay. Remember, return above variable cost, marginal benefit cost ratio, and this time, break-even analysis. Break-even analysis, or BY, okay? What is the theory behind break-even analysis? Break-even analysis is it's almost the same as in your finance or in your accounting, cost-profit volume analysis. That means to say, in here, what is very relevant is computing for break-even yield. That means at break-even, there is zero profit, okay? You proceed in your activity beyond break-even yield, that means it's already profitable. Okay, break-even yield is computed as yield over output required to recover the variable cost. It's given in the formula you have here, PN, which is actually the break-even yield times PN. The PN here is actually the PN is the output of the new technology, output price of the new technology. No, so you have the formula is PN, or the output price of the new technology, times break-even yield. So what you need to solve is the break-even yield. So that means the price of the output of the new technology will become a denominator of these two items here. So break-even yield is actually, you have the result of that will be break-even yield. TVN or TVCN is total variable cost of new technology. You have return above variable cost of traditional technology. Okay, traditional technology. And then you have here the output price of the new technology. Okay, because your baseline here is traditional cost, traditional cost, traditional, return above traditional variable cost, kung naabay bintaha, kung magamit kag new technology, no? So that is the intuition there. Now, given all this, you have return above variable cost of traditional technology, which is 7,000. You have total variable cost of new technology, price of the output of the new technology, and return above variable cost of the new technology. Remember, no? The return above variable cost of the current technology or traditional technology is equals to the return above variable cost of the new technology. Applying the formula, BY is equals to TVCN plus RAVCT all over PN. Okay? So that means that is the result. No? Using that, you have 90 plus 70 all over 100 because the PN is 100. You have 160,000 divided by 100. Then that is your break-even yield, which is 1,600 kilograms. Take note of this, the notation of the new and the traditional technology. We're computing here break-even yield in physical units. Okay? Now, physical units, yeah, because all these are, the peso here is canceled. Okay? Remember, you have here the price, okay? Sorry. The price of N is 100 pesos per kilo. Okay, price of output N. So that means to say, makancel nimo ang peso, mahabilin kilograms. Wala siyang kilograms. Okay? So, you have example in enterprise budget for 1 hectare organic cucumber production. Okay, you have here, these are the gross income, marketable yield. You have 300,000 direct materials. Okay, these are the direct materials. These are the direct materials again. And then the labor, plowing, harrowing. And then you have, excuse me, the direct material cost, direct material seeds, etc. And then you also have direct materials, carbonized rice hull. And then you have labor as also part of variable cost. And then you have another is part of labor for variable cost. And then you also have variable cost again for labor and other items. And then you also have total variable cost and then the fixed cost. Okay, remember, the fixed cost, ang imong depreciation, and then permanent laborers and land rent. Okay, and land rent. So you have here your interest on capital is a variable cost because it will change depending on the amount of capital you actually use, no? So you have total variable cost and total fixed cost. So almost like you complete all the cost item. So plugging everything into this format, gross income, okay, is equals to 300,000, which is actually total variable cost. And then you have also total fixed cost, total cash cost, etc. The total cost is 177. The net income is gross income minus total cost. That is your 122,000. Income above variable cost. So how did we do that? Above variable cost. That means you deduct to the 300,000 all other costs except variable cost. So, imong iset aside ang variable cost, which is 136, and then you have deduct everything aside from except variable cost, then you have the 163,000. Okay? And then you also have return above cash cost. Okay? Gross income, remember, gross income minus cash cost. That means to say, that is your return above cash cost. 300,000. And then minus 143, and then something like that. If you remember the formula, which you need to, but you didn't need to memorize if you understand the concept. But if you do memorize, you will not get lost. Okay? Return above variable cost, gross income minus, return above fixed cost. That means, i-deduct ni mo tanang cost except fixed cost. Return above variable cost, i-deduct ni mo tanang kuan cost except variable cost. Maunang return above variable cost. And then, return to labor. What do you think are you going to do? Deduct all cost except labor. Okay? So, maunang return to labor. Okay? Maunang imong kuan? Imong return to labor. Deduct all cost except labor. Okay? Now, those are the cost and return analysis that can be used for ex ante or for ex post. Now let's go to investment analysis. The investment analysis is something straightforward. Okay, you have what is an investment? It can either be ex ante, or which is done to check the attractiveness of proposed investment. Okay, so you have these differences in income and investment analysis. Okay, differences between income and investment analysis. Kanina, income analysis, matong-hantong himo, cost and return, partial budgeting, etc. No? Now, this time, we go for investment analysis. Okay, general objective, check the current performance. Ang investment, check the attractiveness of future additional investment. Period usually analyzed, individual year, ang kaning investment, useful life of the project, and so on. What about off-farm income? In income analysis, off-farm income not excluded or they are excluded. Cash and non-cash included. Okay, in the investment analysis. Also, for home consumption included in both column, time value of money ang income analysis undiscounted, while the investment is discounted. That means gi-factor in nimo ang effect of time. Okay. Now, performance criteria. In income analysis, performance criteria is return to capital, return to labor, etc. Return to above fixed cost. These are income analysis performance criteria. What about investment? Investment is actually return to additional resource generated. Mga financial indicators you have in PB, BCR and IRR, while ang sa income analysis profitability region or profit region ang gitan-aw niya na. Okay, so differences between income and investment analysis, it follows the principle of discounted cash flow. Okay, remember, you cannot perform the investment analysis without deriving, setting up, generating the farm enterprise cash flow statement. Okay, I think you know that in your accounting, how to set up a cash flow. So, to as a cash flow, kuhaon ang mga values para gamiton sa investment analysis. Okay, it also compares streams of benefits and cost over the lifespan of the project. Consider the time value of money. Okay. What is time value of money? Time value, very, very familiar phrase by G.P. Gittinger, World Bank economic consultant. He said that a peso received today is better than a peso received tomorrow. Okay? Ang peso, nganiana, gunita na nimo, is much better than a peso dawatunon pa nimo sunod simana. Okay? So, it's really the time value of money. That means, if you make discounting, in other words, you make future values, translate that to present value now. What is the value of that? That amount to be received future, in an end future from now, what is the value of that today? That is the essence of time value of money or using the discounting process. Okay, present values are better than same values in the future. Okay, kay piso karon ug piso gihapon ug sa sunod semana alugi ka kay nanay time bidi pa lang nimo madawat ng piso kay 2 weeks from now while karon piso na. Okay, so for example, if a gamay nga manok nga naana imong nagunita na ready na para ihaon is much better than tambok nga manok gukdonon pa dito sa kalibutan. So it's better to have it now because the value, the time value of money is very high. Time dimension is considered with the use of discounting. Okay, you employ discounting to harmonize, to homogenize the effect of time. Okay, so what is discounting? The prices by which future sum is translated to present values. The formula for by discounting is we use the any value multiplied by the discount factor is discounted amount. The discount factor is this one, 1 over 1 plus the rate, okay, 1 plus R, or R is actually a rate of interest, okay? You have 1 plus R, 1 over 1 plus R times T, or the number of periods you are going to consider. If year 1, T becomes 1. If year 2, T becomes 2, especially kung streams of benefits accruing every period of time. Okay, no? Using this formula, you multiply the any value in the future by the discount factor, then you are reducing the value of that particular money to the current. To the current. Imong i-tanaw niya, unspila may value ano sa current. Current, pa, current value, no? So, discount factor, for example, this one, the rate is 12%, and then you have number of periods considered in the investment is 5, and then you have a discount factor is, you have 1 over 1 plus what? 1 plus 0.12. Okay, 0.12. Times 5 man ang T. So, times to the power 5 is equals to 5%. You multiply this one, you multiply this 0.56 with any other values in the future, then you have the, for example, the fifth, no? Ang kanang ikalima katuig. Now, if you have ikalima katuig, if you have this, what? If you have this amount of discounted value of 0.56, at 5 years nga ano, 5 years nga panahon, what does it mean? It means that ang peso karon, okay, or ang peso 5 years from now is valued at 56 centavos karon. Mao'y ipasabot ana, no? So that means you reduce all values to present condition. So peso karon, yeah, nagyapong tagan, gyapong ang peso 5 years from now, musugot baka, you receive that peso 5 years from now, it's actually not anymore 1 peso. It's actually 56 centavos, no? So it's really something like that. So investment analysis, how to do it? Identify and estimate the total capital requirements. Identify and estimate the equity and credit needs. And then you have estimate the projected cost and return benefits. And then you have developed a projected financial statement, cash flow. Okay, you know already how to do how to make a cash flow from your accounting. Then the cash flow statement to adito kuhaon ang mga values. Determine the appropriate discount rate. So usually, ang discount rate is actually the interest rate of the money in the bank. Mo-loan ka karon, pila may interest rate karon? Mo-loan ka, 12%. So the discount factor is 0.12. Okay, that means ang iba ang the discount rate is 0.12, but the discount factor is 1 over 1.12 to the power, depending on the number of years, to the power n. Okay, so you have that. Calculate the financial measures of the project. And then conduct sensitivity analysis. Let's rehearse that particular steps. Financial or economic measures of project worth. Remember, you can do this formula, either economic value or financial value, depending on kung saan mo paggamit. Okay? If you are looking at performance analysis using the price in the market, then you have what? you have private profitability because that is what is existing in the market. So you have that, you have to use financial value or financial analysis. But if you are looking at comparative advantage analysis or comparably, what is this value with respect to the global or world price? So we use the economic value or economic price. Okay? So that all values, whether financial or economic, maurang yapon o ano, o result. Or for example, if you use net present value and then you use financial price according to market price lang imong gigamit, then you have net present value. Pwede na imubutang ang FNPB o imong gigamit sa mga values are economic prices, you have ENPB, economic net present value. So you also have benefit cost ratio. That means to say you have the benefit cost ratio, you have how much for every for every amount of benefit that you generate, okay, for every amount of benefit that you generate, pila may imong gasto anak, okay? So that means, or the other way around is, for every benefit that you can incur, pila may imong gasto di ana. If you spend less than the benefit, then that's profitable, okay? So if you use economic values, then it is economic BCR. You also have internal rate of return or EIRR. So internal rate of return, we will explain that in a short while. Let's deal with net present value first. Okay, NPV or net present value is the summation. Okay, it's equal to the summation of, what is this? You have BT minus CT. Okay, that is what? BT is benefit at time T and cost at time T. That means to say, oh, naakay benefit now, minus nimo sa cost, ana, net benefit all over the discount factor, then you have the net present value. Remember, the discount rate is the interest rate in the bank. Okay? It could be you have the time T there, it could be N number of years, depending on the length of the project life. Okay? So you have there the decision rule for NPV, it should be greater than zero. Positive nga ni, that means to say, taking all factors together, taking the future value together, kung more than, greater than zero ang result, say 100 or whatever, 1,000 or 50,000, then that investment is worthwhile as far as net present value is concerned. Okay? Example, you have this, year zero, year one, two, three, and then you have here the benefit, then you have here cost. So benefit minus cost, you have the positive result here. But usually, ang year one, negative. Why? Investment phase pa man siya. Okay? So what happens? At 12% nga discount on the interest rate, so you have year zero, ang imong T is zero. Okay? That means, wala pa nimo gi-discount na. Kay, unsa man, present man na. And then you have year two, year one, year two, and then year three, graduated siya. And then the NPV of all these values is equals to 1.82, which is still favorable. Okay? And then you have benefit cost ratio between the ratio between discounted streams of benefit and discounted streams of cost. It is also computed as benefit, okay, a time T all over the discount factor. Okay? Or yeah, all over the, or times 1 plus R to the power T. The T there signifies how many years to consider. Okay? Just like, for example, the benefit here, the decision rule for benefit is accept project if BCR is greater than 1. Okay? That means, for example, 1.49 BCR. Okay? That means for every cost ng imong baga, for every peso ng imong gastoon nga cost, you get 1.49 or 1.5, you get 150. Okay, you get 150. So that means na kay ginansya nga 50 centavos for every peso kung BCR imong gamiton. Okay, just like this one. So you have 1 to 3 nga number of years, you have the net benefit. Benefit minus cost, mao ni imong net benefit. You get the benefit cost ratio at 12%. Okay? Benefit cost ratio at 12%, you just have to what? To get the benefit cost ratio at year 0, at year 1, at year 2, year 3, and then all over. Okay? You have the discount factor, no? The discount factor. This is the net benefit now, no? The net benefit, the benefit, you discount the benefit, okay? This one is the value for the benefit, and then you also discount the cost. This one are the cost. You discount that using the and then compute the BCR. Imong i-divide ang imong discounted benefit over discounted cost, then you get the answer for to be 1.06. Okay, that means for every 1 peso nga cost, 1.06. Okay, gyapon. Ganun siya, gyapon ka. Considering the time horizon that you are looking at. No? Now, the internal rate of return. The internal rate of return is actually the rate of interest that equates NPV to zero. Okay? NPV to zero. That means to say, you bring everything now, and then pila may internal rate of return. Because NPV is zero at time zero. Okay? NPV is zero at time zero. That means to say, you reduce everything to pila interest rate ni mo gamiton. That is internal rate of return. First, calculate using, it can be done using interpolation, using this particular formula, and then where DR is discount rate, NPV, or the net present value. Now, this is the classical formula. But actually, internal rate of return is clickable in Excel. Dali ra kaayo. You can click the function keys, and then the function, you get the financials. Now, you can locate for internal rate of return. I-highlight nimo imong mga net cash flow. I-highlight nimo to siya from time zero, from T0 to T whatever, and then you click the internal rate of return, it will compute the internal rate of return. The decision rule is accept the IRR value or proceed with the project if IRR is actually greater than opportunity cost of borrowing. For example, muhulang pagkwarta, gamitin mo sa investment at 18%, yan mo ay available. Then, compute nimo ang imong IRR, 25%. So, go. Favorable na siya. Or, you can also use the IRR of similar project. O, na-compare magkagduha ka project. Na-project dire, IRR mauni. Yan na po'y laing project, IRR mauni, taas-taas. So, kana nga project, mas desirable over the other. Okay? So, that is how we arrive at the decision rule for NPV. Okay? There is what we call as payback. Payback is actually how long are you going to recover all your cost, especially fixed cost. Okay, kanus ang makamurecover sa imong mga gasto, imong fixed cost. Very important ang fixed cost. Kaya maumagunay, ang variable cost, ma-recover man ani mo at every period. But ang fixed cost, makakaibaw kanus ani mo ma-recover. So that means to say you have to at least have an idea in terms of kanus ani mo mabawi imong fixed cost. Okay? That is the simplistic definition of payback period. The payback period is initial capital investment over average annual benefit. Lain-lain man ang annual net benefit ang project. So kanus aman nga mabawi nimo ang imong fixed cost. Okay? Kung nigasto kag fixed cost nga 1 million, kanus aman ka makakuha gyud sa imong first million sa project. Para ang sunod ana payback period na, no? So you have this. The year, and then the benefit, okay? And then the cost. And then this is the net benefit. So, that is your net benefit. So, you have to pila may imong average annual cost. The payback period, initial investment over average annual net benefit. Okay? Sa imong average annual, diin matakuha aning 14 investment money sa fixed cost. You remember, at time zero, wala pa'y production. But you already have a fixed cost of 14 million. Okay? So, ang kaning 14 million, kanus-a man na nimo mabayran? Okay? Kanus-a na ma-recover tanan nga 14 million? So, you remember, you have an annual net benefit of 5 million, 8 million, 7 million. So, you just have to add that there, divide that to 14 million. Of course, average that, because that is what? That is an average of 3 years. I-divide na nimo sa 14 million, you get 2.09. That means, in a little over 2 years, 2.1 year, okay, 2.1 years, a little over 2 years, before reaching the third year, nakabayad, naka-recover na nimo imong fixed cost. So that is the meaning of, ano, very important maguning fixed cost, kay, og tag-as og payback period, malkansi ka, you will end up losing, because fixed costs are actually difficult to dispose. Di man na liquid ang fixed cost. You will end up nga na kay mga idle assets. Difficult to sell. So, na-tied up imong kwarta dito. Okay? So, with that case, you have computed NPV, BCR, IRR, o payback period, upat, for investment viability analysis. Okay? We use the 4 measures. Again, NPV, BCR, you also have IRR, and payback period. Now, what is the sensitivity analysis? In other words, you sensitize. In other words, you test the robustness of your estimate. Kung mag-change ang price output, kung mag-change ang price input, or kung mag-shortage ang labor to this much, what will happen to your estimate? Malkansi ba ka or dili? Okay? Sorry for the barkings, no, of the dog. No. And then, in that case, that will also be a what-if technique, sensitivity analysis. So that it is better na mag-set up nga ni kang investment analysis doon na kay automated matrix. Automated matrix, that means to say, na kay Excel file, and then tuwa dito imong mga, imong cash flow. Nga gi-compute nimo kung naka-i-change at any item in the cash flow will automatically change the estimate, either IRR, NPV, or something like that for ease in computation. Niadto, so wala pa rin the benefits or the affordability of computer, manumano nag-compute, utro, whatever change. Change the input cost by 20%, what will happen to IRR or NPV, change or decrease in revenue, something like that, no? You sensitize. So, you can test the following scenarios if you want. Decrease in price of output, decrease in output level, okay, decrease in volume of production, or decrease in price of major input, or increase in price of inputs, or combination of any of those. Okay? Unsa mahitabo sa imong estimate of the 4 measures. NPV, BCR, IRR, and payback period. Okay? Na ako'y amigo who was engaged with in Kwan, like African oil palm production. Okay? So, pagsugod pa lang sa iyang farm, namalit nag-truck. Kay lagi ko no, maura mag-yapon, morinta sila dito, unya, mahal mag-aayo. So, kuan na lang, namalit na lang siyang truck, mga pila to ka-truck, iingi palit, para di na siya morinta. If you look at the strategy, it's almost like valid, but on one risky, say, item, that is the stability of the market. Unsaon, down ang market, what will happen to your, ano, to your cost? You will end up, kung mag-down ang market, you will end up a lot of white elephant fixed cost. Because di man to magamit nimo. Whereas kung variable cost imong pa-operate, karon nga di pa ka-stable ang market, you will have, kung why production, no variable cost. Okay? So, at the end of the 6 or 7 ano, nag-down yung maayo ang market sa African oil palm, then he ended up a lot of other things. What happened? The investors started asking him their investment. Kung saan man, tagaan ni mong ligid, tagaan ni mong makina nga, naaman na diha sa fixed cost. So, it was a bad decision on his part. Okay? Market, very important when you really think about what particular strategy to use. Are you more of the variable cost or are you more of the fixed cost? Well, kung long term ang contract na kaya ni mong recoveron sa imong payback period, okay lang, magkuhan kag invest kag fixed cost. But kung very unstable ang market, you have to be wise in making use of your variable cost. Okay? So with that note, I hope you can you review this material, and I will give you some working papers, no, for you to really familiarize the procedure, and also like we will discuss that next meeting. Okay, so for now, it's let's call it a day, and thank you for listening. Okay, so with that note, I would stop sharing, okay, with and also I'll say goodbye and have a good day for now.